Hi guys, welcome back to another video by Veena's Art of Cakes. My name is Veena Azmanov. I recently made this dinosaur cake and I have a time-lapse video which is about 10 minutes on how I made this cake from start to finish. But it's of course speed up because it's too much information on just 10 minutes. So by popular demand and requested by most of you, I decided to make another one which is going to be a slow version. So some of you might find it boring, but if you prefer the quick version, then please look for that video. And the first thing I'm going to do is of course the spikes, and you got to do this a couple of days in advance, at least 2 days maybe, depending on the weather you are, you know, weather where you are. It's, as long as it dries nice and hard, and you wanted to make sure that it doesn't kind of it holds its shape. So I'm using 100% gum paste, but you can use 50% gum paste and 50% sugar paste. I'm rolling it nice and thin because I do not want them to look bulky, okay? And now if you go to the Google and check on dinosaurs, you can see different shapes. I'm using this teardrop shape. It's not necessary to use a teardrop shape. You can use an oval cutter, will also work. A triangle cutter will also work. And you can also kind of freehand do them randomly, and that will also work, because if you see on Google, there will be different varieties of dinosaurs with different types of spikes, so there's no really right or wrong. You can also go on Google and get some template and you will be able to do that. Now you see this craft texture mat. You can use the texture mat to texture. You can use the back of your knife to give it a little bit of texture. But if you have this tool which I am using, which is called a shell tool, then use that one. Now you don't really need these, you know, pretty fancy loops that I have on mine cutter. But I didn't have another plain one, so I'm using this one. And I'm actually kind of going to really rip off the edges of it so it doesn't look pretty. It looks kind of raggedy, you know. So if you see, and you want to do it on both sides. And when you airbrush them later, they're going to look much nicer because of the texture, okay? So, and it's going to look more natural if it's a little raggedy rather than pretty because it's a dinosaur after all. So that's. And you're gonna do this in various sizes. You're gonna need the large ones for the body, a little medium, and then the smaller ones for the tail. So I basically made four different sizes. I used four different sizes, and I made a few extra just in case of breakage, okay? Because these, as you can see, are thin, but I actually didn't break any at all. I had a few spare which my kids ate as sugar chips. But do make some extra because you never know, some might break, okay? And as you can see, these are the large ones, and they're going to go about so much inside, okay? And next I'm going to put them on a tray and let them dry. For me, they would take normally about 2 days, but you know, if you have dry weather, then 1 day is also enough. But it's important that you do them in advance and make sure that they dry. Now I'm going to do the small, medium, and okay, in exactly the same way that I did the others, but I'm not going to let you just speed up the whole thing. Now next I'm going to use the cake. For the cake, I have 2 9-inch rounds and I have a 6-inch round. Now I just took the 9-inch round and removed a small portion of it for the 6-inch. I didn't make a special 6-inch cake, just took the same batter, same cake mixture, which is a 9-inch. This is my devil's food chocolate cake, which doesn't have a dome, but ideally it would be best to have a cake with a dome. I'm going to cut this into 3/4 and 1/4. So you see this 3/4, okay? So the 3/4 is going to be the stomach, the body, and this 1/4 I'm going to again cut into 2 and make into the tail and the legs, okay? You see that? Okay. That's going to be the legs and tail. Legs and the tail, and this one is going to be the body right there. Okay, now if you, like I said, if you use the cake with the dome, it's much better. Now this is a 6-inch. I'm going to take this and make the head. As you can see, I just cut the two sides. Okay, I'm going to snip off the pointed edge on this side, and that's going to remove the dome so that it sits flush. Okay, and there we go. See, that's more or less my head. Okay, in a minute I'm going to round the corners, but now see, I'm going to make a tail by taking off a little bit of that, like I told you before. going to take the quarter of the 9 inch which I removed earlier and make my tail. Okay, so I'm going to have a sandwich over there for the tail. I'm going to cut a little more of that later. And now I'm going to make my legs. Now you want to make sure that everything is in proportion. You do not want something too long or too big. Like the head has to be in proportion to the body, the legs have to be in proportion to the body, and the tail has to be in proportion to the body. Now right now you can see my tail is too thin and too this thing, but I'm going to build up on that eventually, and you'll see that it is nice and kind of sways with the body, has the same momentum, not just a little tiny tail sticking out in the okay. I'm going to round off all the corners of my cake so that it has a little bit more character rather than just square bits and pieces. Okay, all the extra cake is going to be used up in some way to make the belly later, because like I said, if you can use a cake with the dome, it's great, because then you don't have to do the belly like I have. Now here I'm rounding out the head a bit, just taking off all the excess, kind of the square edges that are there, and just rounding it off. So just kept the same shape, just rounding it off. Okay, see that? Okay, there you go. I'm going to do the same with the legs and the body as well. Okay. And next I'm going to do is sandwich everything with buttercream, lots and lots of buttercream. Then I'm going to crumb coat and second coat, and then we'll move on to fondant. So it's actually this is the most important part of it, getting the shape right. But as you can see, I didn't really do any specific carving. I just basically took the bits and pieces and tried to put them together, and then just now I'm rounding the corners. And that's about that. Now see, I want a little belly over there, okay, so I'm going to use buttercream later and a little bit of the spare cake to make a little belly, because otherwise he looks like a very thin dinosaur. You want a little bit of a stomach for the dinosaur, okay. See that what I'm going to do? I'm showing you right there, okay. But of course it'll only stick together with buttercream. So next let's sandwich it all up. Get all the pieces, extra spare pieces, and get the board cleared up a bit. Okay. There goes the body. Now let's put the tail. Again, we have to sandwich the tail. Just remove the. I'm just going to round off the corners again for the tail and put the tail in place. Okay, and there goes the tail. Next, the head, of course. Again, buttercream, and sandwich the pieces together. And the same thing with the. Now, if you have too much of a gap between the head and the body, use the spare cake to just fill it up a bit. But you do not want a bulky head as well. So, you want to have that softness in the head. Okay, so remember that. And then, of course, you're going to again put the legs in place. And next, I'm going to do the, like I said, extra pieces of cake for the belly. And that's it. Then I'm going to crumb coat and crumb coat. Second coat, I'll show you that in a minute. Okay, now it doesn't look like, you can't see anything what I'm doing on the other side, but actually what I'm doing is just building up the stomach on the other side, just with a little bit of extra cake, not too much. You don't want a big stomach. dinosaur, but you do want to have him kind of look like he's got a belly, not just kind of, you know, a dinosaur is huge, so you want to give it some of that character. And the same thing I'm going to do is, of course, with the tail. I'm going to build up a little bit of the tail. Can you see the tail looks really very sad right now? So you got to build up a little bit, put a little bit of extra cake there. And you see that corner over there near the neck and the body? You have to make sure that they look natural, as in the join. They don't look just like, you know, one big body and one big head, one small head joining up together. You want to give it that little bit of flow, because when you turn the head to the side, you have a little bit of a gap. So use a small piece of cake to fill that gap and make it look more natural. Okay, and you see I've covered, crumb coated the whole head, and now I'm building up the tail like I told you before. You know, just giving it a bit of a kind of natural flow, so kind of have it like a triangle coming down from the back of the body. Okay, so it has kind of a smooth flow from the whole body, looks like it's, you know, in one momentum, not into bits and pieces. You don't. Okay, and then when that is done, I'm going to put it in the fridge for a while, and when the crumb coat is set, I'm going to do a second coat, and I'm going to show you that because this is a slow version. Like I said, I do have a time-lapse version of this video, so at some point, if you get bored of watching this slow version, you can always go back and watch the time-lapse version. Now you see the feet that I've made. I've kind of got to round those up. I haven't rounded those up. Best to round those up, otherwise they look kind of very square. Okay, and where the body meets the board, you want to make sure that when you crumb coat, you kind of, you know, get a little bit of it on the inside, so it looks like it's going in the board rather than, you know, sitting on the board. So you kind of want to give it that rounded, like a 3D effect. Despite the fact that this is a 2D cake, you do want to give it that little bit of an effect that makes it look more rounded. So down at the board, you're going to just take it on the inside, so it kind of has that curve on the inside. And then, of course, later when you cover with the fondant and when you put the grass and all that other effects, it'll look natural. But you do want to give the body a little rounded effect, like it's going inside the board. Okay, now I'm just crumb coating and rounding off everything. Oh yeah, and this is my vanilla buttercream recipe, which is, I have a video and the recipes on my blog as well. So you can go to my website, venusoutofcakes.com, and you get all the recipes there, the devil's food chocolate cake, the buttercream recipe, as well as my homemade sugar paste recipe. Okay, now I'm going to show you quickly how I just, you know, nothing fancy, just going to give it a second coat, because you see how I'm rounding out the corners at the bottom, just kind of making sure that it's okay. And once this is done, then what we're going to do is just make sure that we have the eyes in place. Okay, so we get the socket for the eyes done. And after the eye sockets, we're going to put a little bit of a mouth. Now, I do not want to cut the cake for the mouth, so what I'm going to do is put some black sugar paste, and you will see in a minute. When you put the black sugar paste, it gives you the illusion of space. So, now my crumb coat is almost done, okay? And like I said, I'm going to put it in the fridge and let it set for a while, okay? And you see, I'm making a socket, the space for the eyes. You gotta have an ex if you don't know how, where to put the eyes, they're not in right in front, they're kind of on two sides of the face. And I'm just going to use some spare sugar paste to make the, you know, kind of lids so that they kind of have that. And like I told you, for the mouth, I'm not going to cut the mouth. I'm going to just use some black sugar paste and make a kind of a, can use a rounded cutter and I thought I was showing you that, but for some reason it's not there. Not sure why. Yeah, there it is. But I guess the video. Sorry, but that's what I did. For some reason, it didn't come. Okay, so now I've rolled up my sugar base. I'm using, lizard skin texture mat that I have. If you don't have a texture mat, you can use your round cutter and kind of put that all over the dinosaur, and you'll have the effect of the same thing. It's kind of a five number round piping tip. Okay, and then I see what I'm doing with the eyes. I am just cutting off this place that I actually put the black patch for the mouth. Now my knife is not very sharp, but a sharp knife works great for this job. Actually, an X-Acto knife works great for this job, but for some reason I'm not using one here. Okay, now once that's done, I'm going to again use the texture mat to kind of highlight places where I must have kind of, while rubbing the dinosaur in sugar paste in place, must have taken it off or something like that. But now I'm going to make the nostrils. I made two holes, but I'm going to kind of use the ball tool and kind of bring those out so that they actually look more natural. Now, I'm not going to put the eyes right now because we have to airbrush. We don't want a white dinosaur. Now, if you do not have an airbrush and you want to do this without an airbrush, then you would put a yellow or maybe even a green sugar paste on this at this point of time. And you would do the same thing with your spikes. You would make them in green. Okay? So, now next we're going to do is airbrush them. So, you see, you want to make sure that you take care of all these little things before you airbrush, because once you airbrush, you do not want to touch the airbrush cake, because then, okay. So, see what I told you about using the texture mat? I'm just going to kind of get, okay. And next we're going to, going to show you how to airbrush the spikes and the cake. Okay, so it's time to airbrush the spikes and the dinosaur. But like I said earlier in the beginning, if you do not have an airbrush, then what you would do is make these in the base color. So for example, if you were making a yellow dinosaur, yellowish orange, then you would make the spikes in yellow and cover the dinosaur in yellow first, in yellow sugar paste, and then give highlights with the orange petal dust and a dry brush, so not wet but dry, okay? And you would highlight and use the orange to give it highlights. You can even use green to add a little bit more of highlight. If you were doing like a green dinosaur, then you would make a light green base color and then add dark green and yellow, so that way it would give you more of a contrast. So you would make the spikes in light green and cover the dinosaur in light green sugar paste. Use a nice large brush and use large, because it's kind of easier to give that texture. You don't want a small brush, because then you'll be more like painting. You want to kind of add a little bit of highlights everywhere, so you use a little bit of a thicker brush and use maybe yellow or and dark green, and then highlight it in that way. Okay, now here I'm using yellow. I'm going to color all the spikes in yellow first, and then use a little bit of orange or red to kind of highlight just the center. So you see I've done the yellow, now I'm doing the orange, and you see I'm doing kind of just in the center, just a blob in the center, and then later I'm going to give it from far away a little bit of a spray of the red, so kind of the colors blend in together. Now the same thing with the cake. Like I said, you would do the base color instead of doing it white like me. Okay? Now, the highlight color that you get when you do an airbrush is a lot different when you do actually a cake with, just yellow sugar paste. You can see the difference. You will notice that it makes a big difference. The way you airbrush is also makes a big difference, because, for example, if you hold the airbrush too close, you get kind of patches. So it's best to hold the airbrush at a certain angle, so the color sprays evenly all over the place. Okay, But for example, if you're doing a dinosaur, then you do not want a smooth spray. You want kind of to give it add a bit more character. So as you can see, in certain places I'm doing kind of a patchy look, so they're kind of too close, in some places it's too far, but kind of giving it a bit more character and a little bit more depth for the colors. Now I'm not very good at airbrushing because I barely do it myself, but the little that I know, that's what I'm sharing with you, and I'm sure there's a lot more to learn for me about airbrushing as well. So now I've finished my, I'm using the second color, which is, I'm using an orangish red. Okay, either you can use red or orange, and that's the color I'm doing. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the spikes on now. Okay, and then I'm going to spray with the spikes on, so the whole thing blends together. Okay, now I finished off with this yellow and red in the video, but then after I did that, you know, the cake is for a guy, and the yellow and red kind of gave it a very feminine look, at least to me. Yeah, my husband and kids thought that it was great, but I thought a little bit of green might add a bit more character, so I went on and added a little bit more green. But as you can see, I'm using the red right now. And actually, it looks really nice and pretty. That's where I had a problem, that it was looking pretty. So I wanted it to look a little bit more masculine. I don't know why, but the green made me feel like that. But so I did add a little bit of green to it, and I didn't show that on the video because I wasn't sure what was whether it was going to be a good idea or not. But it was just an impulse, and I decided to take a little bit of green and kind of just spray all over. Okay, now I'm going to put the spikes like I said before. Okay, start with the large and then, you know, taper down to the medium and the small. Okay, there goes the medium. Okay, and then to his small ones. Okay, and three on the head. Actually, not necessarily three, you can put as many as you want. Okay, some on the head and some on just above the nose, the smaller ones. Okay, and there's no right or wrong to this actually. It all depends on what looks nice to you. Okay, and you can see how pretty that looks. Now I'm going to take my, because you know the edges of the spikes are still white, so I'm going to kind of give it a nice spray on that, so it'll kind of blend in with the cake. Okay, so I want to have that white sheen on, a white highlight on top. It'll look kind of red. Okay, and this is actually where I stopped airbrushing, when I changed my mind and added the green. So you will see that in the next picture, there's a little bit of green added to my, okay, here you see a little bit of green added to it. Okay, and now I'm making the eyes. So basically the eyes are just two white balls, large white balls with two tiny black balls. Okay, so nothing good, this thing. And then above that I added, just the way I showed you before, and on the inside, you know, a small piece of sugar paste to make the eyelids. And now I'm making the teeth, and I use a little bit of orangish to kind of add a bit of dirt on the teeth, brownish rather, to add a little bit of dirt on the teeth, because I didn't want, you know, a very clean dinosaur. And then of course I used some green for the grass. You know, I kind of covered the board in green and added a little bit of grass in the green royal icing, and some stones kind of to give it that effect. And I added the nails for his toes, and I added the number three, I added the name, and I was done with the cake. Just covered the cake board with you know, the sides with the ribbon, and that's all. And that's, I hope you learned something from this video, and I hope you found it useful. I know it's going to be a little long, the video, but like I said, there is a time-lapse version of this, so at all times you can go back and watch that video. It's less than 10 minutes, and you can see the whole cake made from start to finish without sitting and listening to my boring voice. Well, I do hope you learned something from me today on this cake, and there'll be more coming up. Upcoming next is going to be a baby bump cake and a baby belly cake. Bye bye for now.